Control flow expressions like if and else are great when we are just executing a statement of code once. But what about when we want to execute some code more than once? In that case, loops come to the rescue. A loop runs through a block of code repeatedly until a condition is met or we tell it to stop executing. In Rust, there are three kinds of loops: loop, while, and for. Let's talk about each one. First up, I'll focus on a loop. The loop keyword in Rust is used to execute over a block of code forever until it is stopped or the program quits. Let's take a look at the most basic implementation of a loop. Here in the code example, you see inside the main function, we use the loop keyword, and then within braces, there's a println macro line that says I loop forever. Currently, this loop will just do that. It will run through and print this statement over and over. Instead of having this code run infinitely, the break keyword can be used. When the break keyword is encountered, the program will stop executing the loop and move on to the next line of code. Whenever you use a loop, you'll want to include a break keyword at some point to stop the loop. Loops are used in scenarios when you know an operation might fail and need to give it another try. Next, let's talk about while loops. While loops are referred to as conditional loops. While the condition they specify is true, the loop will run continuously. When the condition is met or becomes false, the program exits the loop, stops, and continues with the program. A simple while loop looks like this. Let a mutable number is equal to 3. While the number is not equal to 0, we're going to print out the number and then decrement the number by 1. We're going to go through this while loop until the number is equal to 0. And that's when we will break out of that loop and continue on to the next line, or we'll print out liftoff to the output window. What's awesome about while loops is that they eliminate the need for multiple if and else expressions, and they conditionally repeat as opposed to the loop. And lastly, there are for loops. For loops are best for iterating over elements in a collection, like an array. With each pass of the for loop, values are extracted from an iterator. In this code sample, inside of the main function, we define an array called A with 5 elements. The code iterates through each element in the array and binds it to the element variable. Then the value is printed. Once the end of the array is reached, the code will continue on executing. The same thing can be achieved with a while loop, but a for loop is much more concise. In addition, it eliminates the chance of bugs or errors from possibly going beyond the range of the elements in the array. For these reasons, for loops tend to be the most commonly used over while loops. In the next video, let's look at some more examples of loops.